Just imagine listening to President Barack Obama say your name in one of his speeches. Avondale Mayor Marie Lopez Rogers never imagined it would be her own name she would hear in a speech the president gave at the National Council of La Raza's annual conference in Washington, D.C. He told her story of being a child of migrant farm workers who worked the fields in Avondale. Here's what President Obama said at the conference.
You know, recently I heard the story of a participant at this gathering that we had at the White House that I was telling you about at the top of my speech. So this participant's name was Marie Lopez Rogers. And Marie was born to migrant farm workers in Avondale, Arizona. As a young girl, she and her brother would help their parents in the cotton fields. And I'm assuming the temperatures were sort of like they've been the last couple of days here in D.C. And it was in those cotton fields that Marie's father would tell her, if you don't want to be working in this heat, you better stay in school. And so that's what Marie did. And because of that, because of the tireless, back-breaking work of her parents, because of their willingness to struggle and sacrifice so that one day their children wouldn't have to, Marie became the first in her family to go to college. And interestingly, she now works at the very site where she used to pick cotton. Except now City Hall sits there and Marie is the town's mayor. That's the promise of America. That is why we love this country so much. That is why all of us are here. That's why I am here.
Recently, I had the opportunity to talk to Mayor Marie Lopez Rogers about her reaction to the president's speech and also about the city of Avondale. Mayor, thank you so much for joining us on Horizonte. It's a pleasure to have you here with us. Let's start with a little bit of background. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm the mayor of the city of Avondale, Arizona, and I've been mayor for about 5 years. I grew up out there and worked alongside my parents and worked in community organizing, community work, and now I'm the mayor of the city.
Now, that work alongside your parents is actually the subject of the central focus of this interview, which was the mention that President Obama made of you, and we'll get to that, but tell us about that part of your life. When you say working alongside your parents, that has a very special meaning.
Well, my parents were migrant farm workers for Goodyear Farms, where they grew cotton for tires then, and during World War II, they used the tires for the airplanes. And so we picked the cotton that was out there. And I was a child, and we would go out to the fields. I'd go out with them, and I'd help them. And as 8 years old to teenagers, you know, we all helped out in the fields.
And at some point, you got interested in politics.
Well, I was very active in my community. I grew up out there in the Avondale area. And so I was always helping people in my community through systems, whether it was an education system, a government system. So it was just, to me, another step of helping people through those systems.
Now, before we get to President Obama, let's talk about Avondale and how it's changed over the years from when you were growing up to the point in time when you became mayor.
Right. Well, certainly it's changed a lot since I grew up in the year, actually, 2000, the last census, it was 35,000 people. We're now at 76,000 people. So in that short time span, it's really changed a lot. We used to be an agricultural community. Then we were a bedroom community to Phoenix, and now we're building our own, if you will, with businesses and work and play and all the things that communities like.
Now, part of that building also has to do with buildings literally on the spot where you used to work.
Exactly right. On the spot where I'm working now, the City Hall is actually where I used to work. It was a field that the City Hall was built upon.
Now, how have things changed in Avondale for its Latino Hispanic population?
Well, things have changed because of the work that we used to do and now have had to change, and is more of a construction and more of retail, and so people have gone back to school actually and retrained themselves, and many of them. A lot of the families that have lived there as long as I have now have their children there, and so they've done We have a young population, actually, of 29 years old is our median age, and so there's a lot of young families with children now.
What about the demographics? How do those break down in terms of the numbers of minorities?
It's about half and half. It's about 50% Hispanic.
And we want to talk about what President Obama said, but that was at the NCLR convention, and you actually talked to him before that, and that's what led to his commenting about you. So that was what, at a Cinco de Mayo celebration?
Yes, there was a Cinco de Mayo event at the White House, and so I had been invited. And so we were there and had the opportunity, as he was talking about how the Hispanic community had given back to this country, I had a chance to tell him my story. I feel like it's the American dream. I am also second vice president for the National League of Cities, and so those kinds of opportunities to me came because of the mentoring that I received all the way to now, actually.
So you had that discussion mm-hmm. in the White House. Did you have any inkling that you might be hearing that story coming from his lips months later?
No, not at all. I was surprised, shocked, and excited. There were many feelings going on at the same time.
And what we're talking about is the president took some time out from the current debates and negotiations on the debt ceiling, raising the debt ceiling,
right.
To attend the NCLR, National Council for La Raza,
that's right.
Conference. You weren't there.
No, I was not. I had just returned a week prior from another conference, Building One America. And so
that was in Washington.
And that was in Washington, D.C.
But you left before
So
you
I left, and then he gave a speech to the conference there.
So tell us about that. As I understand, you were watching it live from your computer?
I was. I was at my computer at my desk and tuned it in, and he gave a great speech and then talked about what Hispanics have given to this country and how the struggles that we have had, and so then told my story.
And give us a flavor for what he said about you. I know we got the basic facts, but how he described you.
Well, he said that he had met a participant at an event, and her name was Marie Lopez Rogers, and
And you're watching this, and you had no idea this was going to happen.
That's right. I'm hearing my name, and he talked about the story that I just gave you, that I worked alongside my parents, and even though they had struggled, and even though they worked hard, they made sure that we had an education, told the story about my dad, that my dad had told me when I was working in the fields with him, if you don't want to be working out here in the heat, then you better stay in school. And so he was telling that story, and he said, we have hopes for our children just like they had hopes for her.
Did you get a lot of phone calls after that?
Yes, I did. A lot of phone calls, well-wishing, lots of support. I'm still in awe of the whole thing. I just can't believe it. To me, it's my life. I've lived it, and I would have never known that he would have actually mentioned it.
Let's backtrack a little bit. Mm-hmm. The trip you were in Washington on most recently, you said Building One America.
Yes.
What's that about?
Well, Building One America is looking at the grassroots community, whether it's faith community, business community, the education system, and municipalities, and how do we work together as suburbs to create a better community for our, and then not only in our own communities, but as a nation.
Now, you were already well known in Maricopa County, pretty high profile Latino politician, office holder. Now with the president specifically mentioning you, what does it feel to have that role, to be viewed as a very high profile Latino politician and office holder?
I'm very humbled by it all. I just can't believe the recognition, I guess, at that level. I feel like, you know, we've all done a lot in this country to make our lives better. We've all worked really hard to make our lives successful. And so to be recognized like that is overwhelming for me.
And provide some opportunities for you to serve as a mentor and an inspiration
yes.
to others. Have you had those kinds of experiences?
Well, absolutely. I mean, when I go into classrooms and they see this face, it's wonderful to see that they would be able to recognize that they too can be mayor, they too can be secretary of labor, they could do whatever they want, they could be president of the United States. And so that to me gives me hope for our future.
Mayor, as is true of all mayors, I'm sure you're very, very proud of your city. And so I want to end this interview by allowing you to talk about what you see as the future of Avondale.
Well, I see the future of Avondale as very hopeful. Like I said, we have a median age of 29, so that means we have a very young community, young professionals looking for work, looking for ways to make their community and quality of life better, and certainly we're working to do that.
Marie Lopez Rogers, Mayor of City of Avondale, thank you so much for joining us on Horizonte.
Thank you, Jose.